Today I'm going to show you a few tweaks you can apply to an image to transform a sunny summer scene into a cold and snowy winter blizzard. The process starts with some colour adjustments to remove the warm hues, then we'll add a white overlay to certain parts of the image to represent frost or snow. I'll then show you some easy steps to add a realistic snow overlay to your photographs. The image I'm working with in this tutorial is this outdoors photo from unsplash.com. The first portion of this tutorial works best with landscape images that contain lots of detailed elements like grass and trees, but the snowy overlay we'll be adding later works great with photographs that already have snow on the ground. The original size of this image is 6,000 pixels, so for the sake of this tutorial I'm going to scale it down to 3,000 pixels. The scale of the document just might affect the values of any filters we add later. So I begin by adding a hue and saturation adjustment layer. In the properties panel, change the drop down menu to each color channel in turn and move the saturation slider to remove the warmth from the image. It's usually the yellow and green channels that require the most adjustment. In this example, the guy's coat is affected when adjusting the cyan channel, so that's one I'll leave alone to retain that color information. Select the background layer, then go to select and color range. Alter the settings to sampled colors with the localized color clusters option checked. Then change the selection preview to grayscale and make sure the range is at 100%. Click around the image to sample parts of the grassy foreground area to try and find a good selection that balances between containing a good portion of white without blowing out the image too much. Once you've found a selection that looks okay, you can tweak the fuzziness slider to alter the contrast. Add a new layer while the selection is active, then use the Command and Backspace shortcut to fill the area with white. Press Command and D or go to Select and Deselect. If the effect doesn't look quite right, step backwards with the Command, Alt and D shortcut and try again with a different sample area in the Color Range menu. Otherwise, change the opacity to around 80% to take the edge off this white overlay. The white overlay gives a nice snowy or frosty appearance on the ground, but it might be applied to other areas where it isn't required. Add a layer mask, then use a soft brush to paint away any unwanted areas like the sky. You can press the X key to switch the foreground and background colours around in order to restore the mask as you paint. Drag the background layer onto the new icon or use the Command and J shortcut to make a duplicate. Drag this duplicate to the top of the layer stack and change its blending mode to soft light. Reduce the opacity to 30% to bring back some contrast to the image. Add a solid colour adjustment layer and choose a bright cyan colour. Change the blending mode to soft light and reduce the opacity to 10% to give the image a cold blue colour cast. To finish off the effect with a blizzard, add a new layer and fill it with white using the Command and Backspace shortcut. Go to Filter, Noise and Add Noise and configure the settings to the max 400% with the Gaussian and Monochromatic options checked. Head back to Filter, Blur and Gaussian Blur and choose 1 pixel to soften the noise effect. Then go to Filter, Blur and Motion Blur. Choose a random diagonal direction for your snow to fall and set the distance to 5 pixels. To transform this noise overlay into snow, go to Image Adjustments and Levels. Move the shadows slider on the left all the way over to the right. Keep an eye on the preview to determine how dense or sparse you want your snowflakes, depending how severe your snowstorm is going to be. Press Command and T to transform, then drag the corner handle while holding both the Shift and Alt keys to scale up this layer slightly. Now, scaling up raster artwork does result in fuzzy pixels, but in this case it's actually what we want to enhance the appearance of snow. Change the blending mode to screen to see the snowflakes overlaid onto your photograph. Add another new layer and follow the same steps of filling the layer with white, adding a noise filter followed by a 1 pixel Gaussian blur and a motion blur. In the motion blur settings, tweak the angle slightly to randomize the direction of the snowflakes. Adjust the levels for this layer, moving that shadow slider a little further to make this snowflake's layer a little more sparse, then scale it up a little larger than the other layer. Change the blending mode to screen to see this additional snow layer helps add more depth to the effect. Add a third noise layer with the Gaussian and motion blur settings. This time adjust the levels and scale the layer even more. The three layers of snowflakes help add some realism to the effect with a mixture of larger flakes that are closer to the camera and smaller snowflakes in the distance. Adding the snow overlay is a great way to complement a photograph that already features a snowy scene, but using those initial adjustments can help you completely change the weather within a picture that might have otherwise been taken on a nice sunny day. So if you enjoyed this tutorial or learnt anything new, a thumbs up would be really appreciated to help spread the word. Stick around by subscribing to the Spoon Graphics YouTube channel, and feel free to download my huge bundle of design resources over at my Spoon Graphics website. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one.